Greetings, 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 my VCon Malaysia, V family all over the world. Guys, I don't know why, but the master plan, I get to record my Wednesday message on the closing day of VCon. It's Wednesday, it's almost 1 a.m. We just finished everything for VCon, all right, 2022. And I'm here in my secret dugout somewhere behind in a dark corner of the arena where I tried my best to run VCon from here. And I'm emotional, I'm excited, I'm sad because I'm going to miss all of you that were here at VCon. I mean, miss you already. I don't know what to do tomorrow morning because every morning I went up on stage and said, good morning, make some noise, we Malaysia. Tomorrow morning, I may end up doing this alone in my room. And for all of you who've been watching my Wednesday message, thank you for your loyalty and belief. All right? And I just want to tell you, this is how the Wednesday message started. All right? I promised to make a video for 8 weeks after VCon to sort of follow through with the participants of VCon. And that 8 weeks today has changed to 400 over weeks. Almost 9 years of Wednesday messages. The idea started here in Penang, all right, when I did the first supposed follow-up to VCon Wednesday message. It happened to be a Wednesday that we put it out there and became a Wednesday message. Now, this VCon was unbelievable. 15,000 people, the V partners, AVPs, all right, V councils, the core, the alliance, the great ones, Japadas, Bismarck, and Dato Sri Vijay Ishwaran. And 5 days, four nights of click after click after click after click after click after click, the magic, the passion of you guys who were here, the wisdom, the power, the inspiration from the speakers who went up on stage, the testimonies. All right, Sania Mirza, all right, the number one tennis player from India was here as one of our guest speakers. The whole culmination of this VCon, after almost 3 years of no VCons because of the pandemic, made me have mixed emotions. All right, I was so proud of the work done by the V corporate family, putting this VCon together. The QNET Carnival was unbelievable. But most importantly, going up on that stage, seeing the faces of 15,000 people that belong to Dato Sri Vijay's family, seeing that sparkle in their eye by day three, seeing tears in their eyes when they found their dream, seeing the fire in their eyes when they said, I am a warrior! All right? All of that just reminded me of why we are here. Why I'm proud to be a student, a downline of Japa and Dato Sri Vijay. Because they founded this company, QNET. They founded this family, the V, with the clear intention of changing people's lives, of impacting people's lives, of giving the common man and common woman with the uncommon dream a chance to make their dream a reality. All I can say is if you came to VCon, you know why I'm crazily excited right now. And you did not come to VCon, at least you understand who we are and why you should be proud to be part of QNET, be part of the V. Regardless of what they say, we are here to stay, guys. It's been 24 years and I'm looking forward for the next 24. By then, I'll be like maybe 30 years old, okay? Which legally makes me six right now. I want to remind all the participants of VCon of what I shared on stage, like a wrap-up, and also to share for those who did not come to VCon. So at least you get a glimpse and understand, all right, what VCon is about, all right? Firstly, all my behind-the-scenes, will be on my Instagram, all right, for the next 5 days. All right, I want you to get a feel of what happened in week one. I started with day one, the opening night, where I went up on stage and invited everyone home. The message of welcome home is a representation that VCon is no longer an event. It's almost like a pilgrimage that people come to wash off the negativity, reignite the fire in their heart, get clarity for them to go out there and conquer the world. I brought up the founders, especially Dato Sri Vijay, celebrated his birthday with a giant cake, simply unbelievable. On day two, I helped everyone, I hope I did, find their dream. And right now, you can hear Latika. And if you came to VCon, or you've ever been to any VCon, you know what Latika is about. Latika is about finding your dream, finding the dream. The dream you're willing to fight for, the dream you're willing to die for, the dream that nobody can steal away from you, no amount of challenges can kill, that it will survive, it will keep growing, that dream becomes your purpose, the reason why you breathe every day. That dream is something that you will hang on to for dear life. That dream is the fuel for you to keep moving on your presentación and your TAT and opening up new markets and building new markets. That dream becomes you. And I shared about my dream, which is my Amma. And I stood there and watching that video of Amma always makes me proud that I am her son. That I was blessed to have a mother like her. It was simply unbelievable. And I pray and hope you guys found your dream. Never let it go. Don't let anyone steal it. On day two, I came up in the morning, crazy morning, no sleep, losing my voice, this sexy voice I have right now. And I spoke about the decision, the decision, the decision, the decision. The QNET must become a big decision, not just another decision. It's not where you go for lunch. It's not what color t-shirt you're going to wear. It's like marriage. It's like having kids. It's a lifelong commitment. This decision must be a decision that you will keep alive no matter what, because the whole world is going to try to kill your decision, because sad to say, 99% of society does not want to see you succeed, does not want to see you become financially free. Don't ask me why. It has to do a lot with the human ego. That's the whole message completely. But I want you to make QNET a big decision. A decision that you will never stop. No pause button. Consistent. A big decision. And you must affirm that decision with the words, I can, I will, I must. I can, I will, I must. I can, I will, I must. That affirmation. That once you make the decision, there's no turning back. Because there's nothing to turn back to. You don't want to go back to that life of go to work, come back home, go to work, come back home, go to work, come back home. You want to keep moving forward. You want to keep the decision alive, evolving, growing, and becoming more powerful. Unbelievable day. And day four, all right, I went up and spoke about what all of you out there are facing every day. And it's okay. It's called rejection. I spoke about Dato Sri Vijay's story about rejection. Professor Yamakura, the tough, painful prospect, all right, where his upline before told him that 100 rejections, you are amateur. 1,000 rejections, you become a professional. All right, 10,000 rejections, baby, you are financially free. Are you guys with me? And I told them that you cannot stop a rejection. It's going to happen. Even the best presentation, even I get rejected. Japa gets rejected. Dato Sri Vijay gets rejected. That's the industry we are in. That's life. Not everyone is going to embrace QNET and hold hands and sing Kumbaya. All right? So what I realized that it's all in our mind. You cannot control what you cannot control. But you can control how you react to it. So I told the 15,000 people to have a paradigm shift. Start loving the rejection. Then there's no more nervousness, no more pain. Your presentation goes perfectly. And I played that song. I don't care, I love it. That song is my national anthem. I told them, if there's a country called the V, our president will be Dato Sri Vijayeshwaran, of course. All right. Japa will be our vice president. I will be Minister of Financial Freedom. All right, and our national anthem will be I Don't Care. I love it. So what if you get rejected? That's part and parcel of our business. As Dato Sri always says, some will, some won't. So what? Someone's waiting somewhere. Are you guys with me? No? SW. So keep going. Get rejected. 100 rejections, amateur. 1,000 rejections, professional. 10,000 rejections, you'll be on week on stage as a V partner telling your story, I guarantee you. And you got to stay strong, not to quit. Because the only reason why people quit is they can't handle rejections. So if you get them to handle rejections and embrace it and love it with this I don't care, I love it mantra or national anthem of our country, the V, then they will survive. And the only rule about network marketing is nothing. It's very simple. Let me tell you this, my heart to yours. You cannot fail in network marketing. You only fail when you quit. The only thing about network marketing is if you don't quit, you will make it. If you don't quit, you will make it. If you don't quit, you will make it. Remember that. And then we come to the final day, a few hours ago. Day 5, mind-blowing. All right, ACC2, Kalai wanted me to go up on stage and cover all of these topics. So I went up on stage. I spoke about everything. All right, guys. And I spoke about the ultimate fear that we all have. That we are driven by a fear that we cannot see, we cannot identify, and sometimes we don't know whether it exists. That the ultimate fear of the human race is the fear of what people think of them. That is the ultimate fear. You fear what people think of you. No. Don't say, no, I don't chew if I'm confident. No. We all do. Even I do sometimes. All right? And the day you stop fearing what people think of you, and I got everyone, 15,000 people, to let go, to let loose, to set themselves free. And we all acted like monkeys, all right? Because once you let go, you're free from that burden of what people think of you. I don't have that burden anymore, thanks to Japa, thanks to Dato Sri Vijay, right? So stop worrying about what people think of you. Stop listening to the world, and I promise you one day the world will listen to you guys. So keep doing whatever you want. Be brave, be vocal. All right, go out there, go after your dream non-stop. Don't fear what people think of you, bottom line. Then, I spoke about being a warrior. In this planet of ours, there's only two types of people, wimps and warriors. And anyone and everyone who has achieved financial freedom, they have one thing, they are a warrior. And I hope and pray that I turn the 15,000 people at VCon into warriors. Right, a few hours ago at VCon. Because if you want to succeed in QNET, you have to be a warrior. Every challenge, every problem, every rejection, every relative that doesn't support, every newspaper article, every Google search, every government agency, every downline who quits, every time your network collapses and you have to rebuild. All right, whatever the challenge is, ultimately, the only way you will succeed, the only way you will achieve your destination of financial freedom is one thing. Switch it on to warrior mode. Take it off. Throw away and repeat after me. I am a warrior. One more time. I am a warrior. I can hear you. One more time. I am a warrior. Once you are a warrior permanently, you conquer the world. That was VCon. We closed it. Dato, me, Japa, and all the V ambassadors on stage. Unbelievable. Balloons drop. We announced VCon 2022 in March next year. Buy your tickets now so you get a seat, because we always sold out. It was magical. It reminded me a lot of my mother. It reminded me about how proud I am to be a student of Japa and Dato Sri Vijay. It reaffirmed my loyalty to them and their vision. It reminded me of why I do this. It reminded me of how much I love you guys and how much I'm going to miss you guys. Simply put, it was one of the most magical VCons ever. See you at the next VCon. Get the ticket. I love you guys. And thank you for being part of this amazing 5 days. I love you guys. धड़क धड़क ढोल ताश धड़क धड़क भंडारा झड़क
ಜಡಗು ಮಲ್ಲಾಡಿ ಕಡಕ ತಡಗು ಬಡಕು ಸಲಿ ಚಟಕ ಮಟಕ ಫಟಕ ಸಲಿ ದುಶ್ಮನ್ ಕಿ ದೇಖೋ ಜೋ ಫಟ್ ಲಾವ್ಲಿ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ ಚಿಂಗಾರಿ ಬರಿ 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 ಬರಿ